Tiger Woods is the 100th U.S. Open champion in history.
The 1896 U.S. Open was just the second time that the U.S. Open was to be contested. It was a critical time for the organization.
One of the great stories in golf that really needs to be known more is the story of John Shippen.
John Shippen's legacy is still incredibly relevant. Here's this man who is, you know, an American born. So he's not just the first African-American golf pro, he really is the first American-born golf pro, period. It's a truly remarkable story because it occurred at such an early time in golf.
The 1890s were tough. It was tough to be an African-American. We had two societies. African-Americans were second-class citizens.
After Reconstruction, you did not have what Lincoln had hoped for. You wound up having such a disparity in hopes and possibilities between blacks and whites.
The national trend was one in which the races were being increasingly separated across the spectrum. And in fact, just a few months before the 1896 U.S. Open, the Supreme Court had issued a landmark ruling that essentially made racial segregation the law of the land.
That was really the backdrop under which the U.S. Open in 1896 was contested. You really couldn't separate that championship from what was going on in the rest of the United States at the time.
John Shippen was the son of a former slave. His father had gone to Howard University and traveled around to various places around the country, serving as a Presbyterian minister.
And his father winds up being assigned to work on the Shinnecock Reservation on Long Island.
John Shippen was first exposed to the game at the age of 13. He lived nearby Shinnecock Hills, and he started to work over at the club as a caddy, making golf clubs, working with a local club professional. He actually started teaching lessons. He really, at the very young age, started to flourish and prosper in golf.
He learned the game under Willie Dunn, the head pro there at Shinnecock, and he became very good at it.
And he became one of the best players in the club. So when the club was hosting the second U.S. Open in 1896, the club members decided that he and another caddy, Oscar Bunn, who was a Native American of Shinnecock descent, actually, they decided that those two would represent the club and play in the 1896 U.S. Open.
In the early years of the U.S. Open, the field largely comprised Scottish and English professionals who were immigrants to this country and really helped golf grow from its roots in America. Those professionals, when they learned that John Shippen was going to play in the U.S. Open, along with his friend Oscar Bunn, they objected. They came to the USGA, and specifically the USGA president, Theodore Havemeyer, and said, if Shippen and Bunn are allowed to compete in the championship, we're going to refuse to play.
Theodore Havemeyer had the admirable values to be able to say to them, no, John Shippen and Oscar Bunn are playing, and if they're the only two competitors in the tournament, so be it.
Theodore Havemeyer had the foresight to be able to say that justice was going to be more important than any sort of racism or prejudice that some of the other players were putting out at the time.
U.S. Open looked and felt a little different in 1896 from the way it looks today. 28 players playing on a golf course that was just over 4,400 yards long. But it was also only 36 holes, so two rounds that were played on a single day.
John Shippen was not a long hitter. He was extraordinarily straight, and he was an outstanding putter.
Shippen shrugs off the challenge. He shrugs off the difficulty and the question of whether or not he would be allowed to play, and he has a terrific first round.
He finishes the first round shooting 78, so he's tied for second, two shots off the lead.
Shippen's really strong play continues in that second round. He goes out, has a terrific front nine. He is very much in contention.
He finishes the 36 holes, seven shots back.
He finishes in sixth place. You know, otherwise we might be here talking about John Shippen, the second US Open champion.
It obviously would have been a landmark win had John Shippen been able to win that US Open. But all told, even without winning, him participating and playing so well in that US Open validated the decisions made by Theodore Havemeyer, validated the decisions by the Shinnecock Hills Golf Club members.
Havemeyer, by doing the right thing in 1896, he sort of set the ethos for the game with that gesture. You had one man who needed to be defended, and you had another man who was willing to step up and defend him.
John Shippen's legacy is the man who, seeing a world around him becoming increasingly racially segregated, nevertheless continued to fight and achieved integration in a sport considered elite.
You had this wonderful moment where this young African-American professional, in fact, the very first golf professional born in the United States, as a 16-year-old, comes to play at Shinnecock Hills in the second US Open and comes oh so close to actually capturing that title.